Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Today's wisdom will be coming from out of the Gospel of John, John chapter 19, verses 26 and 27, and Matthew's chapter number 27, verses 45 through 46. And our theme today is the family tree, the family tree. Of course, this week as we take a look back over what happened over 2,000 years ago as Jesus at Calvary Cross, the place of skull, at the place of Golgotha, as he began to give his seven last word, his seven saying. We looked at two of them on yesterday, forgiveness and favor. We seen Jesus pray it for us. And of course, the thief on the right hand who recognized his sinful condition and asked Jesus to forgive him and remember him. He received the favor of God. Today, as we take a closer look at this third and fourth word, of course, we see really a family tree. And one of the things that we find at a family tree is love. And of course, we see, first of all, the love of God, that he would allow his son to die on the tree. We see the love of Jesus as he loved his father, that he would submit to the will of God. And we see the love of Mary and John. They're there at the tree. They are there witnessing Jesus. And Jesus has so much love for Mary and John that Jesus says to his mother, he says, and to the disciple he loved, he says, behold thy mother, and woman, behold thy son. And from that day forward, that disciple took him to his own house. Of course, when we are truly in the family of God, the tree will connect us to God through Jesus Christ, and it will connect us to one another. The Bible says, a new commandment I given unto you, that you love one another as I love you. By this the world will know that you are truly followers of me, because you have loved one for another. Of course, Mary loved the Lord. John loved the Lord, and therefore he took her to the house. And of course, at the family tree, this fourth word, we'll find people feeling left out, feeling lonely, feeling abandonment. Of course, Jesus was there at the cross from the 6th until the 9th hour. The Bible said there was darkness all over the land from 12 noon to 3 p.m. It was darkness all over the land. And finally, at 3 o'clock, Jesus broke his silence and cried out, said, Father, why has thou have forsaken me? Felt that he was forsaken, felt that he was in a place of darkness. But if we look at this mysterious word, if we look at it and take a closer look, we'll begin to understand that that was the love of God, that even he would turn his back on his son so that you and I would become sons of God. Jesus would go in a place of darkness so you and I could be a part of the light. He would feel abandoned so that you and I would never ever be abandoned. He would be left out so that you and I can be brought back in. Listen, this all happened at the family tree. Please join me on Holy Thursday at Emmanuel Baptist Church, 2129 Highway 1 South, where we will be having the last seven sayings at the cross at 6:30 p.m. I pray as always that God would bless you, that he would be gracious unto you and give you peace. That's my prayer for you and your family today. The family tree.